The umpires for today's match will be Daniel Basto Rivero from Mexico and Duvon Henlon from Jamaica. The reserve umpire is Andreas Ledesma from Argentina. Please stand for the playing of the national anthems for Brazil and Trinidad and Tobago. Thank you.
Augusto Rivero from Mexico, and on the other side from Jamaica is Devon Henlon. Brazil versus Trinidad and Tobago. This is Pool B action. The first match of the tournament for Trinidad, they got stuck in Port of Spain due to visa problems, while Brazil's been here earlier. My name is
here again. I'll be providing you the play-by-play commentary today. A little windy up in the tower. You'll probably hear a bit of that sound against our microphones. Joining you today, it's great to have Scott Sanderson, who provides an analysis. Scott, an ex-Canadian international, in fact, a defending champion. Well, not quite defending, but he's certainly the existing, one of the existing Canadian Cup champions, having played for Canada in 2009. Scott, welcome to the TV Tower. Tell me about this game, two postseason ranked teams. What do you think about the chances we've won with?
Thanks very much, Ray. Great to be here. I think it's a good game ahead of us. Brazil's showing a really good start to the tournament. Heavy favorites, Canada, only managing to squeeze out a 3-1 win. Really high contest for them. Defended well, put a lot of numbers behind the ball. Imagine we'll see some of the same kind of tactics for them today. Sort of that their first game of the tournament here. So, no doubt, knowing that we'll need a result from this to try to make their points. And find all the ones that throughout this tournament. So, I'm looking at a few games here right now. I know it's only the second day of competition, but we've only got 3 matches to play. We really need to make every match.
Recipient of that reverse stick pass. Rostones for Brazil with the ball. He was the lone goal scorer for Brazil in their 3-1 loss to Canada. A heartening result for them for sure. That game was 0-0 at half, and Canada only scored in the 50th minute of that match.
Brazil just coming off of a few matches against Canada out in Vancouver ahead of this tournament, so I think they had some good results towards the end of that stay, and they're obviously bringing that confidence here to Brampton.
Played a six-game series, some against the under-21 Canadian squad, which would have explained some of the closer results, but definitely some close games. Good result, good run here by DeGannis. Gains the foul just outside the circle. Full Brazilian team back, we saw that pattern against Canada. This is Quan Brown running on his own, attacking the circle. Hair flowing behind him. Good run down the end line. He's tripped up by the goalkeeper. The ball's loose, and it's a goal. Quan Brown with most of the work, but it looks like Quan Chan picked up the loose ball and batted it into the net.
Yeah, it was a bit of a goal-mouth scramble there. Not quite sure what happened. A few of the Brazilian players with their hands in the air trying to protest that. Referee allowed play to continue, and Trinidad being clinical in front of the net and finishing it up. Getting on the board nice and early. Really good start for Trinidad here.
1-0 for Trinidad and Tobago. Quan Brown the catalyst, as he so often has been for this Caribbean team. Certainly in the early goings, they've had the majority of the possession. Advance up the right side there, captain. Darren Cowie across into the circle. That reaches all the way to Pierre.
That's a great ball through for Trinidad there on the right-hand side. Found his forward just inside the stroke spot. He's going to want to have that one back, I think. You've got to be clinical from there. When you've got a chance in front of the goal like that, you need to really, at the very least, get that on target, give yourself a chance at a goal.
Yeah, the angle didn't seem right for the choice he made. He was only going to be able to deflect that ball wide. Here's a very good little spin move. Verla able to spin in and out of some space. Loses the ball after that. James plays it back for Trinidad and Tobago to Pierre, and they collect and reestablish their shape. Quan Chan, the goal scorer, scored from all the way in defense. Here's a good ball inside. Gilkiss, and the shot. A very quick release, found a little bit of space and put it across the far post.
I think the umpire's called a third party there, actually, ahead of that. So he's just saying that there was a bit of an obstruction there. One of the Trinidad players stepping in front right before the shot was taken. So even if it went in, it wasn't going to be a goal.
Much easier to find some space when somebody's obstructing for you. It's a long ball there. That's deemed dangerous. We've seen a lot of these long balls, even though they're high, not get called down. International hockey's moved to, you know, lessen the number of whistles to increase the flow. Quan Brown coming up the left-hand side. Opts away from the reverse stick cross. Generates a long corner instead. Powerful blast through the circle. Doesn't connect with anybody.
I think we'll see quite a bit of that today with any sort of free hits in and around the circle inside the 23-meter mark. Trinidad will look for Quan to just generate. That's how they got their first goal, and I imagine they'll be going back to that tactic a fair amount as the day progresses.
We'll look to see if Brazil can come up with a counter strategy, maybe a double team on Quan Brown, but an experienced Trinidad team will have some options other than number 7. Brazil on a bit of a break, stepping up well is DeGannis for Trinidad to break up that play. Trinidad scoring a goal early, something that Brazil didn't concede to the stronger, perhaps stronger Canadian team. DeGannis.
Interesting, Trinidad using a team tactical substitution. So three new forwards coming on, replacing the three forwards who had just spent the first few minutes on the pitch. Wonder if we'll see that continue throughout the day.
Only 6 minutes in and full substitutions. You see the teams with more depth who are able to do wholesale changes like that have an advantage as the halves wear on. Tired legs against fresh ones. I wouldn't want to be playing against a bunch of fresh forwards all the time, Scott. How often do the defenders usually exchange in these kind of matches?
I'd say you're looking at, it's different for each position. So the wing backs, especially if you're playing more of an attacking style, can substitute probably every 10 minutes to 12 minutes. Or if you're playing a very defensive style where your halfbacks aren't overlapping and aren't doing that much attacking, you might even get, an entire half of a half. But your center backs, typically your sweeper, your central defender. Oh, here's a break.
A break. Petrioni centers it. A little bit of a mistrap by Reichenbach. Counterattack now by Trinidad. Oh, there's an interception again. We're getting a little bit of end-to-end hockey here. Risk-taking early on. Good for the spectators. Borges being channeled. Toussaint taking him out left. A foul breaks a bit of the momentum, and Trinidad will recover a bit. Mota plays it back to the middle. A long pass. A lot of work to get that ball through. He doesn't do it. Mota again with a cross. Protecting his feet on defense, Trinidad. Legerton, a veteran back there. They're trying to tie him up, and he managed to get a foul.
Yeah, a good little bit of skill by Legerton there. I think we'll see some more of that end-to-end hockey, Harry, as the match progresses. As you mentioned before, if some tired legs start to come into effect, but also creating different chances will also open up other opportunities. So, you know, we saw that counter from Brazil open another counter for Trinidad, and I think that's the kind of hockey we're going to be seeing here today. Some pressure being put on the defenders, looking for mistakes, and teams will be hoping to capitalize.
Eccles throwing a long ball forward. Scipio for Trinidad Tobago unable to reach that. Vanderheiden. It's Yuri Vanderheiden, the older brother of Patrick Vanderheiden. Who's got the ball now? He passes it on.
That's a good bit of skill through the middle there.
Yeah, head up on the passing. Borges. He's being channeled. Tries to get through three sets of Trinidad six, unable to do that, but gets a foul. Here's a hard drive into the circle. Well trapped by Deganis.
That's Brazil's Verlich coming through there and creating some danger, and I think they'll continue to look to him throughout the day as someone with a bit more skill on their side, be able to make some runs from deep in his own central half through to open up and try to create some scoring opportunities.
Vanderheiden, Rostones with the sweep pass. Rostones with the, as I said, the goal against Canada yesterday. There's an interception and a break. It's 2-on-2 hockey. Legerton's available inside. Quanchan bowling over Rostones. Bit of a physical play there, but no call from Basto Rivero. Borges. First touch allows Toussaint to get back into position, but a good turn and spin, and he's off. Passes it on, and here's Brazil with a few attackers up the right-hand side. Ball into Borges again. Stepping in there is Cowie, and a good outlet pass. Trinidad slowing it up a bit, perhaps, losing their advantage for that fast break.
We're seeing some much more positive hockey here from Brazil. It's good to see.
Rickenbach. Spins and turns. Again, a lot of shirts around there. I don't think at this level, with the ability of these defenders, that you're going to be able to spin and turn and gain advantage without actually using them, the space that's away from the goal. You're right, Scott. Brazil definitely able to move forward better in this match than they had previously. There's a touch. You got to be careful because the own goal rule is in effect.
Yeah, I think just caught the Trinidad goalie by surprise there. Saw it pop up into the air, but none of the Brazilian forwards were able to pounce on that ball as it was coming down. I thought someone might try to create the danger there to earn a penalty corner.
A bit careless by Rucky to kick that ball in the air. Here's a ball into the circle. Well stopped. Just on the edge, says Henlon. Legerton smart enough to play that ball just in front of that shooting circle. Vanderheiden, Rostones, ball's inside. Playing up the middle is often hard work, but they've got possession in the circle. Verle turns, tries to get position. The hands go up from Cowie. That is a foul against Verle.
It's well defended there by Trinidad, bringing numbers towards the ball, not panicking, trying to dive in, giving away any cheap penalty corners, but being composed inside the circle. Very good team tactic there to just be patient, come in with a flat stick, win the ball back, and Vale gives up the free hit.
Looking down the list, a significant number of the Trinidadian players with well into the high double digits in caps and a few over 100 caps for sure, led by Quan Brown here with 280-plus caps. He passes the ball out to the right. Cowie overlapping. Will he cross it? Will he cross it? He is in the circle. There's a little bit of room there. Well defended. Borg is coming back. I thought I saw it edge off somebody's foot, but we play on. Baxio trying to dump it through. Off a foot, inadvertently, smartly done by Deganis, playing his body in the way. Either the player was getting through or the ball, but not both.
Yeah, in that sort of situation, when you're one-on-one with, you know, 35 yards to go, you really need to make sure that that defender is in a good position so that you're not giving away anything for a one-on-one with a keeper.
Well, he was smart enough to play that outside the 23-meter line as well, so even a small thing that could have been deemed intentional wasn't really going to cost the Trinidad team in terms of a penalty corner.
Yeah, smart defending.
Souza. Oh, sorry, that's Ferreira playing right half for Brazil. Little mistrap there, the first touch being so important. Murray takes that ball and moves on. Quan Brown up ahead, there's the pass through, just off his back foot. Van der Heijden stepping up and playing that ball call against Brazil.
Yeah, just for a dangerous ball there, just coming up high into the Trinidad player, creating a bit of danger with the aerial.
1-0 for Trinidad and Tobago. 21 minutes to play in the first half. Lots of time. A good turn. Well, let's see what he does here. Quan Chan, the goal scorer, turns. Moves the ball quickly, in fact. Now he's in the circle. He's looking for a pass. Well intercepted and cleared. Better than cleared to a teammate. Rostelnes picks this up. A good little touch inside. Rickenbach.
Doesn't really follow it up with a positive second touch, unfortunately, and they lose possession there. I'd like to see Brazil just be a little bit more composed. It seems like every time they get the ball now, they're just trying to take a man on one-on-one. The defense had worked very hard there to get the ball out, put together two or three passes, and they've just turned it over a little bit carelessly there. As a defender, you want to take the chance to have a break there. You've done the hard work to get the ball back, and you want to just hold on to that ball.
Not too many opportunities. Possession is a really important characteristic of the game. As you get into the attacking area, it's hard to maintain it because you'll attract a number of defenders. Deganis. Very patient Trinidad when they have the ball at the back. There's a missed aerial ball by Cowie, but they managed to get it up there. And we have Shaquille Daniel running up the right-hand side. Some really large forwards on the Trinidad team. Here's a cross. Daniel and Legerton both playing up in the forward line, and they're sizable individuals, hard to defend against.
Yeah, certainly big targets up there for Trinidad.
Eccles throws the ball in high into a crowded area. Whistled down quite quickly. And then you see Rostones with the aerial ball. There is some space behind, but I think that will find... Oh, no, it
he
doesn't...
He gets it. Oh, but just runs off the end line there, Harry. A really good tactical aerial coming from the back out of Rostones. He's just finding the space in between the Trinidad midfield and defense line into that corner, allowing his forward to run onto that very attacking aerial ball.
We had seen the Argentinian game earlier. If you had tuned in for that, I saw some really precise short aerials, tactical ones, as you say, and they were just beautiful to watch, and that one just out of the reach, perhaps. But very good result, very good kind of style of play for this young Brazilian team. They're trying to qualify for the Olympics in Rio in 3 years, and there's a standard that has been set by the IOC and the FIH, and they have to maintain a top 30 ranking or a top 6 Pan American ranking in order to automatically qualify as hosts and this is a good step forward for them.
Well, this tournament will bring lots of ranking points with it, and so a good performance here will really encourage them to take part in those games.
Sliding play there. Deganis, I think that ball rolled into his shorts, and that's not allowed to be done, but not an intentional foul or anything like that. Rostones with the ball. There's a sweep, and Borges unable to pick that ball up. One of the harder skills in the international game is to be able to pick up a ball like that while you're on the move, and Borges didn't seem to be able to adjust his footwork.
Yeah, that's exactly right. So one of the technical sides of it is really trying to get that ball ahead of you so you're not trying to pick it up beside you. If the ball is beside you, you're just going to be stabbing at it.
Here's a chance. Hard cross into the circle. A touch, a very late touch by Ryu to push that ball behind and out of play. Sliding Butler was ready to make a touch and push that into the goal. Rostonis collects up this weak cross attempt. Almost 5 yards against Trinidad and Tobago. So a small mental error there. They're pretty strict about that five meters, in fact, rule as it gets closer and closer to the attacking circles.
Trinidad looking like they're trying to set up some sort of press here. But it's only coming with the front three forwards and Brazil able to finding some space in behind.
Yeah, that was a glaring gap. But the turnover happens when Brazil tries to run it out. Quan Brown, who else do you want with the ball? He runs and finds the space. The shot on goal is saved. Well saved. Reinbach.
Yeah, really well composed there. Didn't commit one side or another. As Quan was running it down, removing his angle, Reinbach stood tall, made the save.
Even with the speed of Quan Brown, he got channeled by the Brazilian defender. And Reinbach staying on his feet and really looking big in the goal, taking away what could have been a really dangerous situation.
Yeah, that's an important save right there. I mean, you go down 2-0 and it becomes a lot harder for Brazil to get back into this game. So maybe Brazil can get some momentum from that.
Right, if you look at the history, Trinidad has a chance to maybe explode in this game and get a 2-3 goal lead. But Brazil didn't allow Canada to get a large lead until very late. So they've really, really been smart about their defending. And, defending with a good tactic is about hard work, isn't it?
Yeah, it's hard work, it's position, but it's also making sure everyone's on the same page. So you can be working hard, but not working smart. And if you have 10 players on the same page, but one player doing something else, then a good team will find a way to exploit that. Brazil doing well to get numbers behind the ball and making sure that they were all doing that together.
Yeah, that's right. So disciplined Brazilian team. Looking for their first result, down one goal here with 16 minutes to play in the first half. Rostones, a little deception there. He finally does turn back and play it back. Van der Heijden.
Here comes Quan.
Quan trying to put some pressure on, and hearing the footsteps was Michael Guest. And there is Quan again. Good dump pass in. It's close to the post, and Reinbach watches that go wide. Quan probably would look to do something better on that play.
Just looking for Gilkes in there, but he wasn't on the same page there. Just missed out on the pass.
Another turnover. Brown turns and comes into the play. He's into the circle. Room to shoot. Good save. Difficult bouncing ball low. Glove save. Here's Gilkes. He shoots on the short side and another save. Well, let's take a look at Reinbach. Two good saves in that game. I don't know about the rebound control on the glove save, but certainly able to come back and in position to make the next save. Another cross in. Rosanes calmly takes that and steers it outside the circle. Pierre gets the foul there, and Daniel over the ball. No, it goes for Brazil. So an interesting sequence there.
Yeah, again, Reinbach standing tall in goal, keeping Brazil in this game. But they're going to want to ask themselves how they're giving up so many chances at net and going to need to tighten things up in the back there if they want to stay in contention.
Sometimes it's good to bend a little but not break, but Brazil won't get too many chances on goal, or they haven't yet. And so the second goal, as you say, could be a really, really killer one for them. Well, a player like Quan Brown is a bit of an anomaly, certainly the best player likely on the field, and he can do things other people can't. Reverse stick cross by Daniel is punched too high. That's a difficult skill, Scott, in order to be able to cross that ball effectively. I think you got to get your hands lower.
You've got to have a lot of training to get that skill right. It's something that needs a lot of practice, and you know, even something subtle as a change in turf can affect the way that you cross that ball and can start putting the balls higher that you're used to putting on the ground every single time. And exactly right, Harry, in terms of the technical side of things, you want to get nice and low, get your hands close to the ground to make sure that ball is staying flat all the way across, because if you get underneath it a little bit or you come over top of it, the ball's going to go in the air. It's going to be dangerous.
I learned that playing golf, that the wrong kind of contact will get a terrible result for you. Pierre Rostonis patrolling the middle. Quan Brown always seems to be everywhere around the field. Reinbach saving, kicking that rebound. You know what? Reinbach's played great. Some of those rebounds, that one didn't hurt him, but my God, a powerful strike by Daniel coming up was high and wide.
Yeah, I think you're right talking about the rebounds there, Harry. He's really putting himself in a dangerous position there, putting that ball back into the play.
But then again, a goaltender who makes all the first saves is better than one that doesn't.
Yeah, I'd take a goalie like that over somebody who's just picking the ball out of the net, sure.
Twelve minutes to play with Trinidad and Tobago up 1-0 against their Brazil. Scott, what do we know about the rankings of these teams coming into the competition? I think they're fairly closely ranked compared to some of the matches we've seen. There's a bouncy ball in the circle. Reinbach kicking it high. I think he might have been able to let that go. And here we have Brazil clearing a bit with a bit of desperation. Tell me about these two teams. Where are they ranked?
Right, they're very closely ranked indeed, Harry. They are 30th and 32nd in the world. So Trinidad having the slight advantage over their slightly more southern competition. But as we've seen, we've got a lot of energy coming out of Brazil in hopes for that Olympic qualification spot. So they're certainly intent on climbing up the rankings in the world and make themselves getting into that top 30. They also look to their, Brazil will look to their captain, Rostonis, to really lead the charge there in making that step up to the next level. He's one of their more experienced players and certainly dictates things from the back.
Vril with a cross-field scoop. In the offensive zone, it's such a fun thing to watch because it wasn't done before they relaxed some of these danger ball rules, but it doesn't amount to anything. Well-weighted pass. Great skills by James. He turns to the middle. Rostonis, really, really strong challenge there. James had him moving in the wrong direction. He got his left hand down to make a strong challenge and protect his left foot. No penalty corner.
That was a good sequence of play for both teams there. Trinidad piecing some nice passing together, getting themselves in a situation where he could go one-on-one with a defender, getting into the circle, and then the Brazilian defender coming in and Rostonis stepping up and cleaning up the mess there, really making a strong tackle.
Into the circle, turning. James. Well, there, that was very good. He looked like he was going to the inside, went to the outside, and once the defender was off balance, finds the foot.
Yeah, just popping it over the defender's stick. Defender's coming in there nice and hard, low flat stick, thinking he's got the angle, and Trinidad player, nice bit of skill to bounce it over his stick onto the body, earning a penalty corner.
We've seen that the with the less skillful players, they keep the ball on the ground, then it's easier to defend. But once you get that three-dimensional, here you can see it in the replay.
Yeah, as we can see, the first tackle is made. Ball just pumps out a little bit closer towards the baseline, and the Trinidad player realizes defender's flat-footed, sticks low on the ground. As he's coming in, pops it over. Really nicely done.
First penalty corner for Trinidad and Tobago. Quan Brown on his toes, ready to take. The stop is good. There's the drag flick. Not a lot of juice on it. Unable to clear, and finally clearing is Brazil. Not the greatest penalty corner drag flick. Saved by Reinbach and cleared by Brazil. Trinidad looking again.
I think Brown just got off his stick a little bit. I'm sure he'd want to have that one back. We saw that in one of the earlier matches as well, where the ball seems to just not quite be holding onto the player's stick as long as they would like. And so as it's coming off, it's releasing just a bit earlier than they're wanting it to and not getting it as much power as they're hoping.
And we've seen this is a brand new facility here in Brampton, Ontario. A new turf sometimes is bouncy. It's been settling down. I've been hearing from the players that they like it, but it's such a precise skill at the top of the circle. Scott, you did a bit of this stick stopping at the top. You're trying to stop it just an inch outside the circle and have them collect the ball and shoot it all right away with very little time.
Yeah, exactly right.
Long break here. Mendonça, he's got the ball. Well defended by Cowie. Cowie had a long way to run there, put the flat stick down, and there's that. The flat stick tackling against the inexperienced Mendonça is effective.
Yeah, good composure there from the Trinidad defender, waiting, realizing that the player was just going to play it on the ground.
James looking very effective for Trinidad on attack in this second half of the first half. Leaves the ball for Brown. Brown loves running across the center of the pitch and then looking for openings. He now goes to the corner and crosses it through a crowd. He moves it on quickly on that free hit to the end line and generates a penalty corner from outside the circle. Scott, did you see something there? I think the umpire is signaling for some sort of stick infraction.
Yeah, exactly right. I think originally Kwan was trying to get the five-meter infraction, looking for a penalty corner, the Brazil players not being quite five. But as he moved in, they all ran out. If we see on the replay the first foul, and we can see Kwan quickly realizing that the Brazilian players aren't five. Smartly, they all move back, and then the Brazilian defender comes in with a little bit of a stick tackle there, a little too much stick for the umpire's liking, and penalty corner.
A little conversation between the Brazilian team and the umpire. They're trying to delay and understand what's going on that call, but they've got to concentrate here. Kwan Brown with the shot. Right in the top right corner. Clinical finishing. That's fantastic. Penalty corner execution.
It certainly doesn't get much better than that. Kwan making the slight adjustment he needed after that first one wasn't to his liking, and you could see carry that all the way onto his stick as we see the ball come in. Great trap. Player comes in and just carries it off the crossbar, off the ground, inside the net, and a 2-0 lead for Trinidad.
That ball inches, less than an inch from both the post and the crossbar. And as an ex-goalter, I know sometimes those shots on the stick side, you can reach them because you've got that 2.5 foot extra reach, but on the glove side, it's near impossible.
Yeah, if you get that ball right in the corner there, it's a really, you know, you have to rely on your postman to be sharp on that side to be able to bring that down.
Trinidad looking to extend their lead. They have the momentum. Pierre on the end line kept it in. Rostones sweeping the ball out. Smart, composed play.
You know, if we go back to that question you asked earlier, Harry, and we think of that penalty corner, we could really see how Kwan picked up that ball as he was coming in. The ball was trapped, dead stopped, and that's important. If the ball is rolling, it's so much harder for the drag flicker to pick it up cleanly and get a good strike off.
Legerton down the end line. The next penalty corner, we'll take a look and maybe we'll focus on some of the footwork, the crossover footwork the penalty corner striker does, because Kwan Brown is a great example of that classic technique. But there's a lot of crossover and body turning and really leveraging the arms, and it's an amazing thing to watch in slow motion.
Yeah, it's a unique skill for sure, and it's something that every team will rely on, and it can make a difference between finishing in the top half of the tournament or the bottom half of the tournament for many teams if by having a good drag flicker, someone who you can rely on to come through in the crunch. And Kwan Brown there showing us that he's one of his country's finest.
Toussaint with a quick foul and free hit, but he drops it into the circle, not with much intent. Rostana sweeps it out here to Yuri van der Heijden. Decides to go back. Trinidad with a bit of a more aggressive press, kind of a passive aggressive press, would you call it?
Yeah, it's just a bit of a loose press. They're floating there. They're ready to pounce, just waiting to see if there's any sort of mistakes made by Brazil. And when they're ready to go, they'll come with the full team.
Brazil now trying to sustain something in the Trinidad attacking end. Trinidad defending end. Doesn't take too long before the ball is outlet to Gilkes and he gets a foul. So Brazil, they do get the ball up into the attacking end, but they don't really manage to sustain any pressure. And very quickly, I don't know if Trinidad is counterattacking, but they certainly are getting the ball out and into the midfield quickly.
Yeah, it's just slightly disorganized from Brazil in the final third there, giving the ball away cheaply. It's just a few signs of the inexperience coming through there from Brazil. One of the things I'd like to see them do is just value the ball a little bit more, value the possession. And when you make it all the way up into that final third, instead of just trying to take someone on one-on-one, maybe just hold on to that ball a little bit, find a trailing midfielder to come through, play a little bit more in combination.
And you're seeing a little bit of that there. gets disrupted as the white shirts move into that space. We saw a good example of Brazil defending in the last game. So now what you're saying, Scott, is they need to be a bit smarter with the ball as they were when they didn't have the ball.
Exactly right, Harry. I think you know, Brazil's making some big strides here over the last few weeks in Canada and in that test series that we were talking about before, and now here in the Pan Ams, and it's about trying to continue to improve and make those next steps forward. So, you know, they're doing a better job of defending. We saw some of their test matches against Canada, the early ones, you know, score lines of eight goals against, whereas yesterday, the first game of the tournament, only three, and, you know, here, two against Trinidad.
Just a stoppage here. Pierre getting elbowed. And we're going to get a green card suspension. That's number five, is it? Alfonso Mota will sit out.
Mota will drop out, and it'll be interesting to see if Trinidad can capitalize on this one-man advantage. It may not feel like much with 10 against 11, but it can certainly make a difference, and Mota's a key figure for Brazil in defense, so maybe Trinidad can exploit that.
All the patterns change when you're a man down. There's a ball into the circle, driven hard, looking for a touch. Legerton thought it, I don't think he thought anybody touched it. I think he might have been yelling at his teammate because that ball was probably where the coach wanted it.
Yeah, all that time you have above the, with a free hit just above the circle there, you're going to want to run set plays. Each team will have, you know, several variations of what they're looking to do to get that ball in the circle and get the ball in the back of the net.
Often that channel right down the middle isn't open, so Legerton took it and nobody was there to take advantage. You know, for all we're saying about Brazil and their, you know, the focus and their preparation, it's interesting to see a Trinidad team. They have a long history of Pan American Cup hockey, always ranking in the, you know, 3-6 area, consistently coming to these championships and playing well. And you can see they can come off a plane 2 days ago, minimal preparation, certainly on the surface, and still come up with a very strong performance again against a team just slightly behind them in ranking.
Yeah, exactly right, Harry. If you look at the Trinidad team, what the one thing that really stands out is their experience with an average amount of caps of 77 across the board compared to Brazil with 25. Some of that experience showing through, and even not having ideal preparations coming in only a day before your tournament starts, Trinidad able to come in and really make that difference and use that experience.
Rostonis with a sliding challenge. Did well there, actually. Usually you commit too far, but he got up right away. We're in the closing 20 seconds of this first half. Pool B action. Trinidad up 2-0 against Brazil. Rostonis feeds the ball through. Toussaint looking for a last-minute penetration into the circle. Mota runs it out of there. Brazil now not much in the way of a counter. Echoes inside. And I hear a buzzer. The horn's not working, but we have. That's the end of the first half. Good result for Trinidad so far. 2 goals to Brazil's 0 goals. Brazil, not much attack in that half. A couple of possessions in the attacking 25. Trinidad and Tobago, certainly the stronger team. Scott, what do you think? How is this game going to play out in the second half?
Well, I think Brazil's got to really make some changes here. If they want to get back into this game, they're going to need a goal early. 35 minutes is a lot of time, and you know, you can certainly come back, tie, win this game. There's lots of hockey still to be played, but they're going to need to be more clinical in that final third. Look for penalty corners, look for some opportunities, and start driving the game a little bit more. They've had a good stretch of possession from time to time, but really haven't had a chance to take advantage of it. And Trinidad, on the other hand, really clinical in their final third. We're seeing, you know, a great corner finish from Quan Brown. We saw a nice finish inside the, just, you know, 2-3 yards in, cleaning up a rebound in there. And you know, Trinidad is showing their experience, as we mentioned, and now I think they're going to look to just kind of continue on that same vein and really try to solidify this game, get one more goal maybe, and put this game to bed.
Great analysis, Scott. You see Quan Brown walking out the field. We'll do the same and take a short break here. We'll be back in about 8 minutes and bring you the second half of Trinidad versus Brazil. Thank you. We are back for second half action. Brazil versus Trinidad and Tobago. Quan Brown over the ball, ready to start up the match. 2-0 Trinidad and Tobago. Goals from Quan Chan in the third minute. Early lead for Trinidad and Tobago. Quan Brown with a second goal for Trinidad on a penalty corner, 29th minute. Here we go. Brazil in pursuit early, trying to make up some of the difference quickly. Toussaint able to ward off that pressure. Ball goes back and an aerial ball here. Deganis finding the sideline deep in the Brazilian end. They take the ball quickly and move it on. Rostones, their captain, turning, looking for a ball, switches it back. Van der Heijden plays it inside. This is Borges. Long ball, intercepted. Brazil retain the possession and it's off the sideline. Long whistle there. Some equipment fixes necessary. So we take a look inside the Trinidad and Tobago bench.
Yeah, Quan Brown just got a bit of a wrap against his hand there, so it'll be interesting to see if he pops back out into the game or if he's, you know, if it's anything serious and we don't see him again. Definitely keep an eye on that one.
Lots of wraps on the knuckles in this game. See a lot more players wearing gloves on some of their hands. Traditionally, that wasn't very prevalent at all.
That was only for the indoor game, really, Harry. And then in the last, you know, few years, we're seeing it used more and more and more. A hand being part of the stick and inside of a tackle, defenders dropping down to make low, strong tackles along the ground. It's just going to protect you from having your hand broken.
I think it might have something to do. That's a foot on Rostones, but they play on if there's no player nearby. Unnecessary whistles are being eliminated in the international hockey game. Here's a long aerial ball. Oh, it's a bit too high, not getting as deep as Moutet would have liked. Generally, a ball like that's always going to go to the defense because there's time for more than one team to get underneath the ball. Brazilian captain playing it right.
Bit of a half press here coming from Trinidad.
It's hard work for the forwards. There's a good shave tackle. They call that the shave tackle from behind. That
Gilkes, sorry. Yeah, it was a really technically sound running back stick along the ground, seeing the ball the whole way, and just edging it off the attacker's stick.
We've seen a lot of people do an aggressive tackle when running from behind. It's a recipe for making an error and oftentimes getting yourself in trouble with the umpire, but that low trailing tackle is very effective. Moutet to Pierre. He tries to flip it through. A couple of yellow shirts there, but he manages to get a foul. He looks back. Quan Chan puts the ball forward.
It's another shave tackle there.
Interesting chance for Pierre. He one touches it and gets a foot. Gilkes takes it on his own, looking to the end line. Will he turn the corner against Rios? He does. He's at the circle's edge. Ball is steered off the end line by Rios.
Good recognition of space there from Gilkes, seeing that he could get entry into the circle, forcing the defender to make a strong tackle.
Got to take advantage of those small spaces, especially when they lead to the shooting area. There's a good turn by Quan Chan. He's on the left end line. That left end line's become a good offensive area with the advent of all these reverse stick skills by these players.
Yeah, exactly right, Harry. We're seeing a lot more penetration into the circle.
Well, there's an innocent ball into the circle, and it leads to a penalty corner. Pierre had it on the edge, dropped it in play. Scott, I think that just was off a foot, an innocent ball.
Yeah, just a bit of a mistake there from the Brazilians, and we'll have to see what Trinidad can do here, if they're going to punish them or not, but you don't really want to give up any cheap corners like that, you know, unnecessary, and if we look at the replay here, we can see that Trinidad's done well to move the ball in, finds it inside the circle, and then up it goes onto his own player's leg and penalty corner.
Yeah, that's sloppy. That defender had some time to collect that ball and run it cleanly up, but a bit of desperation. Now, as you said, Quan Brown, the penalty corner striker, is off.
So they'll look to Legerton here.
Legerton It wasn't a clean stop, and Leggerton had the ball roll off the inside of his stick. Brazil able to clear. Will they manage a fast break? Not clean up the circle. Up the field is...
Eccles does a good job to step in there and cut that off, but Brazil seems to get it back here.
That's right. Petrocino had a chance, but now we have... I'm thinking that's Piazzo on the far side. It is. He'll go take the long corner as well. Look at Trinidadian team is all the way back in defense, so they've recovered from that corner. It's often a great counterattack opportunity on a broken down penalty corner because there is an advantage on the other end.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you certainly wouldn't want to be giving up penalty corners thinking it was an attacking option for your own team, but if you do well in defending it, the offensive team has committed so many numbers in attack that often you can get a fast break going the other way and it can be a really dangerous situation.
Indeed, Brazil not able to take advantage. Sometimes the aerial ball is the way to go on that. The ground route is also tends to be quicker. Here we have an aerial ball to Gannis. That works effectively. Pierre attacking the left side of the circle. Rostones diving. He's been successful on the dive, but it looks like Henlon, the umpire, is calling that off his body. It seemed quite intentional the way he dove. Oftentimes that leads to a penalty stroke, doesn't it, Scott?
Yeah, exactly. You don't want to be doing anything intentionally that's going to be committing a foul inside that circle. It's going to be the umpire's just waiting to give a stroke at that point. So, you know, in fairness, I can see him arguing with the umpire. Not so sure about that call, but, you know, easily recognize that easily it could be a stroke call against him if he's caught... flailing along the ground intentionally there. Ooh, it was a foot that was stuck out, I think, the original call there, and if the referee deemed that to be intentional, that could have been a stroke.
Back to the live action.
Got Eccles now on top of the circle.
Another missed trap there. Sometime now, reverse stick shot. That still has to be low as the first shot on goal. Well saved, Reinbach, and cleared. Trinidad doing all right when they had the broken down corner to get a shot on goal. They attack directly into the circle. Right inside close. Here's the reverse stick. It just pushed across the face of the goal. Pierre doing most of the work, and on the end of that shot, was it Toussaint who wasn't able to push that
that's
across?
That's exactly right, Harry. And, you know, really great stick work from Pierre there, cutting through the Brazilian defense like butter, and really did a good job trying to set up for his teammate, but just couldn't finish.
Look, a ball goes across and three reverse sticks from the Trinidadian team, unable to stab at that ball and bring it down. Brazil really spreading out a little bit more. Their team is attacking. One player in the attacking 25 on their own 16-yard hit. Ball into the middle. I'm sure Trinidad has seen these sort of positional tactics before and will continue to mark.
Trinidad doing a bit better job here in the second half, just holding on to possession, dictating the game a little bit more. In the first half, it was a bit reactive. This seems much more purposeful from them in the second half.
And pretty comfortable, I guess, with a two-goal lead. You'll see them play quite comfortable until perhaps Brazil closes the margin. They responded yesterday quite quickly. Here's a break. We have James attacking the circle, recovering very well as Vanderheiden. Diving, sliding tackle by Quan Chan. Thought he deserved a foul. He did get that foul in the end. Good teamwork by the two umpires to signal back and forth.
Really good work from James there before stealing that ball and giving himself an opportunity. Just couldn't make much of it, but you know, really strong tackle in there.
Gannis is playing it wide to Pierre. Nobody close to him. He elects to go backwards. Cowie, head up. Strong running with the ball. That's an errant pass that Pierre did something well with, but managed to hit his own shoes.
Trinidad pushing bodies forward here for a little bit of a press. See if Brazil can get out.
Brazil is staying with their... really spread out team looking for an advantage there. So a press combined with a high attacking Brazilian team. Here's a long ball. It looks like it's going to connect. Mendonça, he's in the circle. He's now exited, and there's a drop pass for Borges. He goes to the reverse stick. Is somebody there? There's a shot and a goal! Fantastic. It was the long ball. Borges stayed with it, and Paez, just with one hand, pushed it towards goal.
Yeah, it's a crafty finish there from the Brazilian. I think he's just recognized that anything on net there is going to get a goal for him. So we see the smart play in here into the baseline. Borges does a good job to pull it back, trying to earn the corner, but the ball sneaks through. Goalie's caught out of position, and great finish there.
Really, the strong wrist there. You wouldn't have thought he had enough power, Paez, to put that on net, but...
Yeah, he's done really well there in a number of fronts. One, recognizing that there's the goalie's out of position, and two, recognizing that he really just needed to throw it there quickly.
Here we have another chance. Similar reverse stick shot at goal this time. Great save.
That's much smarter there from our Ryan back in the back there to just push the ball wide when that ball came through the circle. Not putting it back into the middle of the net, forcing Trinidad then to have another play before they can get a shot on. So really much improved there.
Maturing within one game.
It's a good ball across from Meckles.
Bouncing ball is hard for Gilkes. We have time being called right now, and this is a green card away from the play. Perhaps there was a bit of a verbal interchange that Rivero didn't like from Borges.
Yeah, it's about the only thing I can think that could be really hairy. When you see a card coming off the ball, it's either for some sort of push in the back that's happening off the play or a bit of chatter to the umpire.
Chatter gets you 2 minutes. Brazil now down a man. They're playing the similar long ball that gained them their first opportunity and their first goal. Really one for one on their quality opportunities on net.
Trinidad seeming to really be missing Brown there in the middle. Just getting caught in behind.
That's right. He went off with what we thought might be a minor hand injury. Wrap on the knuckles, but now it's been a good 10 minutes that he hasn't been on the pitch. That happened very early in the second half. The score is Brazil 1, Trinidad and Tobago 2. Lots of time to play, 23 minutes remaining in this game. Cowie overlapping. Trinidad and Tobago captain, a drive into the circle. He hits his opposing captain's counterpart on the top of the circle, who tries to clear, but now the ball goes down the right-hand side. There's a dangerous crossing clearance. I say cross because he tried to clear it right across his own goal, and that leads to a penalty corner. That's a little bit of an inexperience by Reyu to be able to choose that option.
Yeah, definitely. I think if we actually even back it up further from that, we'll notice that it was Mendonça who dropped the ball back in an errant pass when his defender had played it up to him. All he needed to do was turn and go forward with the ball, would maintain possession instead, tried to play it back to a defender running forward, and he played it to a Trinidad player, causing this corner against.
So some sloppy play. You work so hard to defend and get the ball, you must at least get it to the sideline to relieve pressure, but better is to play it square to one of your teammates, but certainly not give it back to the Trinidad forwards. Another penalty corner. Again, missing Quan Brown. We'll see what Trinidad comes up with. Here's the ball. It stopped well. The shot is saved. Reinbach down low to make that save, and Brazil clears. Taking the shot was Eccles for Trinidad.
Yeah, Monta doing a good job of clearing that to the sideline as well, not leaving it in a dangerous position.
They're up the left-hand side, spinning and looking for a call. Too many hands in there. These players must continue to play. The long corner's taken. Played back for a better angle. A drive doesn't make it to the circle. Brazil closing the gap hard. Paez able to chase that ball down. Taganis turning. Lays it back to Quan Chan. He's tripped up. We get a long whistle here. Running straight to the sideline. It's a yellow card. That's a minimum of a 5-minute penalty. Paxio ran straight to the sideline.
Yeah, and I'm not surprised here. If we watch the angle of the tackle here, he initially approaches him well, but then just leaning in with his hand on the back and the stick coming through, he's umpire's left with no choice there but to give a yellow card.
And Jackson knew it, ran straight to the sideline. The suspension, whether it's 2, 5, or 10 minutes, starts only once you sit down in that chair beside the technical table, so these players don't argue in those situations when they know they're guilty. Brazil now down a player for a minimum of 5 minutes. We'll get back to you with the length of that card when we find out. That ball's kicked out. Taking no chances is Rheinbach with a Trinidad player on the back step looking for a deflection.
That's a really tough blow for Brazil. They were just getting some momentum, get to the game to within one goal, and then all of a sudden you're down a player. Makes it very challenging.
Cross into the circle. They're going to weather this storm. All of a sudden, very few options up the field for Mendonça.
Yeah, it's actually better for Mendonça. Last time he was in that position, he turned the ball over. So at least this time he's given his team a chance to get a free hit, recollect the position, and start moving in a more positive direction.
A little pressure now. They're trying to control this ball, Ruiz. Body to body against Murray. He's not happy about that. I don't blame him, but the whistle's there.
Now Ruiz doing well there to get out of trouble, keeping possession. Trinidad looking to come with some pressure here. You can see their men moving forward.
An aerial ball buys them a bit of time. And another one. So crisscross, zigzag across the field. It's misplayed. Here's an opportunity to Vanderheide. And Patrick, the younger one, plays the ball inside. That play took some time to develop, but they managed to get something out of it. But very good defending by Pierre to steer that ball to the right side of the circle. We have another chance. Up the end line, attacking is Brazil, and outside the circle generates a penalty corner.
Just a bit of carelessness there from Trinidad in their defense. There was no need to go in there with a heavy stick. There was no danger coming in there. A little bit more patience out there. Keep the attacker, pushing him back towards his own goal. You're up a man. We can see here just getting a little bit too aggressive. Eccles there with a stick challenge, and then the second one, not as bad, but I think it was really the Eccles' first foul that we're seeing that corner being called for.
And it's the combination of skill and speed that's deadly. You use them both at the same time, and the umpires will reward you for that when there's any kind of contact, whether it be the hand or the stick against stick. And Brazil with, I believe, their first penalty corner of the game.
Yeah, that's right, Harry. This is their first, so let's see what they can do.
Two batteries close together. The ball comes out. It stopped well. The drag flick by Borges. First runner chases it down very well. Pierre. Here's that counterattack we were talking about. Trinidad 3-on-3. The ball is out to James. He's on the reverse stick. Rostones challenging him, and it is off the body of Rostones for a penalty corner. There's that counterattack.
Yeah, exactly right, Harry. Trinidad doing a really good job there. First defending the penalty corner. It was a bit slow coming off the stick from Brazil. Trinidad defender came up, did an excellent job to block it, and then a quick counterattack the other way. Two passes into the circle, finding a foot, and it's a penalty corner and a scoring opportunity coming up for Trinidad.
And Rostones, he's been very aggressive with his tackling, but getting his body near the ground is costing him. You can see this in the replay.
Yep, he's not in a bad position here, but he just gets a little bit too close, not guarding his feet, and the Trinidad attacker spots it, plays it right off his foot, and easy penalty corner.
Cat and mouse, protecting your feet but trying to make a jab tackle leaves them exposed.
Yeah, James doing well there.
We come back and we see the penalty corner. It's a drag flick and it's over the net. It must have hit some body against Brazil to deflect over the net.
I think the first runner there is claiming that it's hit him in the forearm and saying that it's dangerous. You can see him pointing there. But the Jamaican umpire not really seeing it in that way. So we're getting another corner. And it was actually not a bad effort from Legerton, so be surprised if we don't see him again here.
The ball, if it makes contact with the first runner above the shin pad, is deemed to be dangerous because it's unlikely to be on net. And Ruiz is really selling this because he might have a welt on his forearm right now. Charging down, penalty corner drag flickers, the ball coming at you at 100 kilometers an hour. Doesn't sound like a fun job.
It's a slow walk back to center, let me tell you, Harry. When you get hit with that ball, it stings. And he's done a good job, done everything he can to help his team there, and hopefully the next guy he'll be thinking the next guy will be stepping up to do the same.
Trinidad with multiple options at the top of the circle, but they're going with the number one, Legerton, and it's a goal. Drag flick, middle left side, clinical finishing, very close to the post.
Yeah, I think it even gets into the inside meshing there, Harry. We'll notice on the replay here where that finishes up, but strong finish from Legerton. Brazil not getting as much pressure as they had in the previous with the previous first runner, and Legerton having more than enough time to pick a spot and fire it in there, bringing the lead back to two goals for Trinidad.
Play starts up. It's 3-1 Trinidad. Brazil reducing the deficit by half, but then getting into card trouble. A couple of greens and then a yellow, and with Piazza off, Wayne Legerton regains the two-goal lead for Trinidad and Tobago. Another hard whistle. Hedlund from Jamaica, the umpire, is having a conversation. He's not going to give out more cards there, but he really wants the teams to calm this down.
Yeah, he's feeling that tensions are getting a little bit high here. He saw a couple sticks that were a little bit higher than maybe he would like, and just telling people, you know, let's just calm down here and get things under control.
Taganis with a aerial ball into a crowd. Pierre thought he had better advantage there. Rostonis, and a good turn here. Verl, will he collect the ball on his side? Yeah, he is able to get a foul there. At least good speed out of Verl. We've seen his speed before.
Yeah, as you were mentioning before, that combination of speed and skill coming from Verl in the middle of the field. I'd like to see a little bit more from him, maybe, trying to find a combination with other players. He seems to be just really driving that on his own.
Lovely ball to Rickenbach. Those short aerials into space. Rickenbach driving the end line. He's in the circle and probably would have liked some more time to develop that play, but the advantage called.
A good little bit of skill with the lifted dribble. Puts the defenders right under it, giving them no option but to really be patient and get them on their toes. So I like that.
Rostonis leading his teammate with the pass. Van der Heijden driving it in. Looked like hit a foot of Eccles outside the circle. Brazil takes the ball back to the hash mark. That's 5 meters away from the shooting circle. Verl plays it back. Rostonis looks right, drives it towards the circle. It's in there, and a shot. Didn't get all of it. Brazil still with the ball, unable to clear. Bit of a scramble there, but the ball goes off the end line. Not much time in there to get a full shot off.
No, that's when you either need to get a really quick, just push the ball at net, try to get something towards the net, or you look for a foul in there and try to get a penalty corner. Brazil not able to do either one of those.
Cowie not with the best aerial, but manages to find his teammates. Spinning here. Toussaint just loses it behind him. And the reverse stick pass, well, less of a pass, more of a clearance. It backs up the Trinidad and Tobago team well into their corner, but it doesn't look like Brazil is interested in putting on a press in this defensive right corner.
No, I think they're just taking their time to reset here and still down a man from that yellow card.
Piazza has served most of his time, but it could have been 10 minutes that he was assessed. So that'll happen in a couple more minutes. We'll know whether he's going to come on anytime soon. Now a reasonable press by Trinidad, and there's a giveaway. And the shot on goal and saved. That was a very sloppy play.
Yeah, rebound control again. I mean, first it was the error that got the ball moving towards the goal and forcing the keeper into taking some action. Letting that go would have been an own goal there, so he made the right decision to try and clear it, but the clearance was poor. Right towards the Trinidad player, and probably should have done better from there. I think he'll want that one back. You know, you're one-on-one with a goalkeeper within the penalty stroke spot. You're going to want to finish that.
Oh, with time to hit it as hard as you want to, but it was an error compounded by another error that gave Trinidad that opportunity. It's the last error that's often the worst one. Turn there, but good defending, solid defending. Moutet. Flat stick again. We need those 3D skills to get through those areas. Murray breaks free. He's looking into the edge of the circle. He knows Legerton's there. He goes on his own, and he scores. What a run by Kyle Murray. He had some options, but decided, hey, let's do this myself.
He made a really smart play there. We'll see it on the replay, but the defender just edges towards the other attacker, and here it comes. First, he does well to battle through those three players. Shows the inside. Quick pull back to the right. Goalie comes out and just manages to slide it into the corner. Great reaction from the Trinidad bench there, with the entire team jumping up and really excited about getting that very important fourth goal, putting this game three goals ahead, which is going to make it very, very difficult for Brazil to get back in here.
Kyle Murray with a zig and zag and a deft touch to pop the ball behind Reinbach.
Yeah, very smart play. It looks like Dwayne Quan Chan here gets a yellow card. Didn't quite see what caused that, but it's definitely not going to help Trinidad's cause.
Trinidad with a three-goal cushion right now. I think Quan Chan, it's a bad time for them to get a yellow card. There's no reason for them to be upset and lose their composure with a three-goal lead. Looks like we have, outside of your frame, Quan Brown has re-entered the field, so it's good to know that he's not injured. I'm not sure Brazil's happy he's back in the field, but happy he's not injured badly, perhaps. Vanderheiden, it's in the circle. Trinidad's O'Connor, Michael O'Connor, swinging the pitch for perhaps the first or second shift. Vanderheiden with the ball here. Verl unable to collect that ball cleanly. Scipio finds his man Pierre inside. Quan Brown comes back for the ball. He's 1-on-3, and that's not going to be easy for him to get through Vanderheiden. Vanderheiden being very, very solid in the Brazilian deep defense. Playing it back to Rostones. Ten minutes to play. Quan Brown collects the ball in midfield, spinning and finding space. His head is up. That's why he's such one of the reasons why he's such a good player. Pierre battling it. Three players pushed from behind.
Smart play by Pierre there just to get that quick free hit started. A lot of Brazilian players committed to that area, trying to get it out and expose the other side.
But less urgency on the Trinidad team, but they still do want to move forward here. In such a short little pool of four-team pool, the goal difference might come into play. There's a reverse stick shot. Not too dangerous from that angle. We had a yellow card. So Trinidad is looking now. We've got our 3 points. It's a 4-1 game. Maybe let's get a few more goals in case goal difference makes a difference later on in the tournament.
100%.
Here's a cross. Or a shot on goal. Reinbach kicks out the left foot. Another high rebound, but that clears the edge of the circle. Given up to O'Connor, Quan Brown overlapping. He's up the right-hand side, keeping that ball in front of him where he has more options. The ball is tipped across the end line for a long corner.
Good challenge coming there with a reverse stick. Not coming in too hot, but composed and strong, and just knocks the ball off the end line, taking away a dangerous situation.
Not too hot, not too cold. An effective tackle. Back on the pitch after his... what was a 10-minute suspension for that infraction earlier.
It's a nice ball out wide. Brazil with a good chance here.
Reinbach finds his own teammate in the middle. Baxo on the trailing of the play would have been a beautiful goal.
Yeah, it was actually the best bit of hockey we've seen from Brazil probably all match, and it's just unfortunate not to finish in the net.
You see some great two-man passing all the time, but when the third man steps up and scores, it's beautiful. Here's the ball into the circle. This is collected. Deganis calmly, very calmly, plays the ball out. Deganis with 42 international matches for Trinidad and Tobago. That's enough experience to feel comfortable clearing balls out of the circle. Something we didn't see necessarily on the Brazilian side, a little bit more panic from them when they get possession, and they don't often, they've made a few mistakes clearing the ball.
Yeah, just that little bit of uncertainty, feeling that pressure and saying, okay, you know what, I just want to get rid of this. I'm not really sure where it's going to go. It just needs to get out of here. And you know, as you'll notice, the more experienced players and teams will really be composed inside that circle. It's no different to having the ball anywhere else in the field. As long as you've got it on your stick, no one else is going to be taking it away from you. You want to find the next pass and move that ball on.
And, you know, time is on your side when you have it there. As long as you have solid possession, somebody will hit your stick and you get a freebie quite often.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And often the forwards from other teams are typically not the best tacklers, let's say, Harry. So if you can just, you know, start moving in towards space, a lot of times you'll get a rash tackle coming in, someone really trying to win the ball with not the greatest technique, and you get that foul that you're talking about.
Long ball forward, overlapping. Toussaint out of space as he's tackled by Rius.
Ball speed here by Trinidad is a bit lacking. It's not really opening things up like the way they want it to.
Aggressive hit by O'Connor there, chipping the ball up dangerously. Six minutes to play in the match. Rosones plays it out to the right to his teammate Yuri van der Heijden. Pattern we've seen again and again. Patrick van der Heijden, his brother, collected that ball, plays it back. Rius twisting against Quan Chan. The second tackle by Cowie was easy.
Yeah, got himself in a really good position there. Knew the attacker was going to be popping that ball through. Just waited for it to come right to his stick. Easy interception.
It's kind of like you set a little trap. One person pressures, the other one kind of does the easy tackle at the end of the day. Channeling is so important on defense because you can't do it all your own. You need teammates' help. Quan Brown, little mistrap on the, well, maybe that was intentional to play it into space. He cuts to the inside looking for a teammate. That aerial ball eludes the Brazilian team. Reinbach with a save. Oh, but the rebound is there, collected and scored.
Gilkes with the finish there. A really good play by Trinidad all the way around. You saw the ball to Quan being played about 30, 40 yards. He played another ball up to his attacker. First shot was a really good one. Great save by the keeper. No one there picking up the rebound. So we'll see it here. Here comes the ball in.
Just outside the frame. There's the shot.
Yeah, the shot. Great save with a hand by keeper, but unfortunately that rebound just bounced right perfectly for Gilkes, who made no mistake and slotted that home.
And I don't think we'll be, it's not going to seem too nice when we say to Reinbach that it's a great save, but if he can play the rebound into a different space, he might not have conceded that goal. But Gilkes right there on the spot to battle that positioning and push that ball into the net.
Yeah, it's a smart play by him to just get into the right, exactly the right spot.
Moutet with a hard cross. That deflection by James is high and wide.
Moutet's played some good balls through today from that right side. He's done well in overlapping, getting himself into a good position, and played some nice hard flat balls across into dangerous spots.
Verl feels comfortable with that ball on the end of his stick. Rostones with a little pop over to Verl again. Good give and go. Over 30, 40 yards. Verl turning and spinning. And it's not too decisive, but that ball gets through. But none of juice on that.
Yeah, Cowie. Just a little bit too much flash for me here. I think you just run right at the defender there. Play the two-on-one nice and simple, and you're through. No need for behind-the-back reverse stick passing there.
It is Brazil, though. They've seen their soccer cousins play. They want to play some flash. Here's a chance. That looked like it was going to be a goal. We can't hear the whistle from here, but it was definitely blown by Basto Riviero well before that.
Yeah, Brazil a little bit disappointed there that they didn't get the advantage. But, you know, they've got the free hit here, and maybe they can do something with it.
We have 3 minutes to play in this game. We're going to have Scott head down to the pitch to do some interviews. Got a replay here on this. This is to the end line. No, this is live action. That ball is high. Scott will be heading down to the pitch to get a couple of interviews. So when the game is over, please stick around to the live streaming. We'll get two players for interviews and their thoughts on this game. It was a close game for quite a while. Trinidad with a two-goal lead going into the half. Brazil with from Bruno Paes scored in the 45th minute to keep it close. But now we've had three goals in succession. Trinidad and Tobago definitely firmly in command. 2 minutes to play. Pool B action. First game for Trinidad and Tobago. Brazil having suffered a loss to Canada 3-1 in their opener. If the score line stays the same, they will fall to the bottom of Pool B. Trinidad and Tobago with a 5-1 win will go to the top of the pool. But of course, Canada and Chile yet to play. 5 p.m. today. Quan Brown spent quite a bit of the second half off the bench, on the bench getting his hand repaired, but scoring the what would be the game-winning goal, the second goal of the game in the 29th minute. Just a clinical penalty corner drag flick. This ball's over the top. DeGannis has been very good for Trinidad on defense. Up the right-hand, left-hand side is Toussaint. And finds James's foot. Brazil looking a little bit frustrated there. A substitution right now. Verl. Bastones, Verl again. Moving well with the ball. He's had this speed, but really running with speed and not having a lot of room, however. This ball's into the circle. Is that off a foot? Here's a shot on goal. Wow, that's well defended by Darren Cowie. A risky place to put your body in, but puts the stick down and makes great contact. Long corner now, 30 seconds to play. Here's a chance for Trinidad and Tobago. It's underneath the goalkeeper. Andre Rock could not get his body out of the way. Penalty corner, and with limited time left, the clock will run down, only 6 seconds to play. We play out all the penalty corners at the end of a half. There's the buzzer. The umpires call time. Rock is feeling like he's injured. Maybe he got that ball cut up underneath him and a whack of the stick along the way. 5-1 currently the score. I think Brazil will take this opportunity to execute a penalty corner. There's the cross in there. A slight deflection. That ball gets caught in between the legs of Rock. It's very difficult to get yourself moving without exposing the goal and perhaps exposing yourself as well. Looks to be okay after a few deep breaths. Brazil set up for this penalty corner. It won't make much consequence to the score. Well, to the score perhaps, but not the pool standings or anything like that, with Trinidad in a 5-1 commanding position. Whole Brazilian squad at the top of the circle with no risk from the defending side of it. Here's the push out. It's well stopped. The direct drag flick, and it's a goal. Beautiful goal. Finished by Verl. Halfway up the left-hand side, it really bulged the twine at the back of the net. Rock may be unable to execute his full proper stride over there, having just suffered an injury. We have a replay here. There's the push out. Solid stop. It is Verl indeed. Great technique. You can see him very low, and that drag flick hits the side of the mesh. Final score will be Trinidad 5, Brazil 2. Brazil scoring their final goal on the final whistle, the penalty corner of the final game. We have a few interviews for you. Scott Sanderson is standing by down on the pitch. As you see the team shake hands, not a lot of work for Rock to do. Conceding 2 goals, Trinidad supporting him with 5 on the offensive end. Brazil really looked stronger against Canada 3-1. I think they might have thought there was more of a chance for them to be in this game and extended themselves. Didn't play a solid defense as they did yesterday. And Trinidad able to take advantage of that, scoring 5 goals, and move themselves into the top of Pool B temporarily, with Chile yet to play their first game and Canada yet to play their second game. They're playing a little later on at 5 p.m. We now have Scott Sanderson ready for an interview. I'm going to turn it over to them soon. Thank you very much. We'll see everybody shortly. Stay tuned right now for 2 live interviews, and at 5 p.m. the Canada versus Chile game. More Pool B action coming from Brampton at the 2013 Men's Pan American Cup. teams are just getting organized here, and well, congratulations on a short little warm down happening. And now we have Quan Brown with Scott Sanderson.
Quan, congratulations on your win today. Tell me a little bit about how it went out there.
Yeah, we're just really pleased with that early goal for the quick start, especially because of how we saw Bill, Brazilians giving Canada so much trouble the day before. So we're really worried about just getting a good early start, and we got that goal quite early, so it settled the nerves, and that makes it quite easy.
How important was today's match for you guys?
It's extremely important. It's one thing winning, but with the way the groups are, this is one of the games we needed to get the three points if we want to have an opportunity to make it through to the semifinals. And it's really important we get this win. So it was our little mini finals.
Right. Yeah. Right, excellent. And so did goal difference ever come into play in your minds?
Well, definitely. Goal difference was definitely a big thing. So when we got the second and third goal, especially the end there with that last short corner, normally, you know, you'd be a little bit careful. We really wanted to keep that ball out because we know it could come down to goal difference at the end.
Perfect. And I saw right at the beginning of the second half, you just took a bit of a knock on your hand. Talk me through that and what's happening.
It must be age. My hand started spasming. I could not grip my hockey stick at all. So it wasn't a knock or anything like that. I just could not grip my stick. So the medical staff worked in it for about 15 minutes. So I got I think the last 10 minutes in the game. So it was all right. I'm about to get in a lot of trouble from the guys for this. So much stick. Yeah.
I bet, and all well deserved. And maybe talk me through that penalty corner goal. I mean, it was a fantastic finish, and the first one you didn't quite get off. So great. Did you make an adjustment, and how did that work for that second one?
I think with the first one I was overthinking, and the second one, well, it just said, let's just have a go and see what happens. And it went exactly to plan. So it was quite nice.
Yeah, it certainly was. It was. It was a great treat for all of us here and for those watching online as well. So congratulations on your win today, and good luck in the rest of the tournament.
Okay, thanks, Oscar. Okay.
And I think we've got a Brazilian player coming up next, and they're going to talk us through how they've done today and what their plans are going forward. And here he comes. Come on in. Hi. How are you?
Yeah, good. How are you?
I'm very well, thanks. So maybe you can tell me a little bit about how the game went today.
It was a long, tough game, of course, and it was more physic as well. And it was a lot of turnovers. They played a more physic as well, and I think yesterday we played a good game against Canada. It was only 3-1, but we lost a lot of energy over there. And you saw that was their first game, and we weren't focusing enough, not enough energy. We didn't put enough energy in the game. And and especially in the second half, you saw that it's going backwards. And there were some good moments, of course. Scored two goals, but it's a long program to 2016. So improving every time, every day.
And is that really your focus for this tournament? You're not really looking towards, you know, necessarily having the greatest results here, but you're actually just building towards, you know, the 2016 goal and making sure that you're getting in a position where you're improving for every match?
Well, it's a combination of both. Of course, we want to get the best of every match, of course, and it's a good experience. But it's we started a program and we played two other tournaments this year. And you see we're improving every day. And you can't expect that we're improving one day to the other like a big, big step. But it's like you have to look forward, but you have to... Every game is an experience, a good experience. And, of course, we want to have the best... Best goal here, and I'm the highest score. So we see game to game.
Yeah, and I really noticed that your level has improved, and you guys have been in Canada for a couple of weeks now.
Yeah.
How has this experience been for your team?
Yeah, every match, if you compare it with Brazil, they only played 10 games in a whole year, and we played like 6 games in 8 days. And you see, it's a good experience. We had the first game, we lost 8-0 against 8-0 against Canada. And if you saw it yesterday, 3-1, it's quite a good result. But we should focus, keep focusing every game. And I think today we didn't reach our level, to be honest. And we have a lot to improve. But it was a good experience, of course, those weeks in Vancouver. And it took a lot of energy, but it's only good. We're building, so that's a good thing.
Fantastic. And now you're heading into your last pool game against Chile in 2 days' time. And what are your thoughts heading into that match?
Well, it's another game, and we have to see it from game to game, of course. And we've got two days to recover, and we're probably going to see some more games of them. Maybe the next game is Chile. And, last time we played was in Rio during the World League. So hopefully we can improve that score. It'll be fantastic. So improving every time.
Great. Well, fantastic. Thank you very much for sharing your thoughts with us, and good luck in the rest of the tournament.
Thanks. No problem. See ya.
And that's all from us from now. We're going to be back here in about half an hour with the start of the Canada and Chile match, and so please join us then.
too fast, go feel my blast. I'm rolling blues, I'm gonna lose. I'm all the animal, I make your move. She's creeping in through your back door. Silent killer queen, looking out for ya. She's invincible, never let you go. Cause tonight she'll be